I will start by commending you all for the resilience and patriotism that you have shown in our collective fight against the biggest health challenge of our generation. As at yesterday, 26 April 2020, some 3 million confirmed cases of COVID-19 have been recorded globally, with about 900,000 recoveries. Unfortunately, some 200,000 people have passed away as a result of this pandemic. The health system and the economies of many nations continue to struggle as a result of the coronavirus pandemic. Nigeria continues to adapt to these new global realities on a daily basis. Today, I will present the facts that they are and explain our plans for the coming months, fully aware that some key variables and assumptions may change in the coming days or weeks. As at this morning, Nigeria had recorded 1,273 cases across 32 states and the FCT. Unfortunately, this includes 40 deaths. I am using this opportunity to express our deepest condolences to the families of all Nigerians that have lost their loved ones as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. This is our collective loss, and we share your grief. Initial models predicted that Nigeria will record an estimated 2,000 confirmed cases in the first months after the index case. This means that despite the increase in the number of confirmed cases recorded in the first 2 weeks, the measures we have put in place thus far have yielded positive outcomes against the projections. The proportion of cases imported from other countries has reduced to only 19% of new cases, showing that our border closures yielded positive results. These are mostly fellow Nigerians returning through our land borders. We will continue to enforce land border arrival protocols as part of the containment strategy. Today, the Nigerian Center for Disease Control has accredited 15 laboratories across the country with an aggregate capacity to undertake 2,500 tests per day across the country. Based on your feedback, Lagos State Government and the FCT, with support from NCDC, have established several sample collection centers. They are also reviewing their laboratory testing strategy to further increase the number of tests they can perform, including the accreditation of selected private laboratories that meet the accreditation criteria. Several new fully equipped treatment and isolation centers have been operationalized across the country, thereby increasing bed capacity to about 3,000. I commend the state governors for the activation of state-level emergency operation centers, establishment of new treatment centers, and the delivery of aggressive risk communication strategies. Over 10,000 healthcare workers have been trained for their protection. Additional personal protective equipment has been distributed to all the states. Although we have experienced logistical challenges, we remain committed to establishing a solid supply chain process to ensure these heroic professionals can work safely and are properly equipped. In keeping with our government's promise to improve the welfare of healthcare workers, we have signed a memorandum of understanding on the provision of hazard allowances and other incentives with key health sector professional associations. We have also procured insurance cover for 5,000 frontline health workers. At this point, I must commend the insurance sector for their support in achieving this within a short period of time. Nigeria has also continued to receive support from the international community, multilateral agencies, the private sector, and public-supported individuals. This support has ensured that critical life-saving equipment and materials, which have become scarce globally, are available for Nigeria through original equipment manufacturers and government-to-government processes. The distribution and expansion of palliatives, which I directed in my earlier broadcast, is still ongoing in a transparent manner. I am mindful of the seeming frustration being faced by expectant citizens. I urge all potential beneficiaries to exercise patience as we continue to fine-tune our logistical and distribution processes working with the state governments. Our security agencies continue to rise to the challenge posed by this unusual situation. While we feel deeply concerned about isolated security incidents, I want to assure all Nigerians that your safety and security remain our primary concern, especially in these difficult and uncertain times. As we focus on protecting lives and properties, we will not tolerate any human rights abuses by our security agencies. The few reported incidences are regrettable, and I want to assure you that the culprits will be brought to justice. I urge all Nigerians to continue to cooperate and show understanding whenever they encounter security agents. Furthermore, for their protection, I have instructed that the personnel of all the security agencies be provided with the necessary personal protective equipment against infection. As we continue to streamline our response in the centers of Lagos and FCT, I am gravely concerned about the unfortunate developments in Kano in recent days. Although an in-depth investigation is still ongoing, we have decided to deploy additional federal government manpower, material, and technical resources to strengthen and support the state government's efforts with immediate effect. In Kano, and indeed many other states that are recording new cases, preliminary findings show that such cases are mostly from interstate travel and emerging community transmission. Drawing from this, I implore all Nigerians to continue to adhere strictly to the advisories published by the Presidential Task Force and the Nigeria Center for Disease Control. These include regular hand washing, physical distancing, wearing of face masks coverings in public, avoidance of non-essential movement and travels, and avoidance of large gatherings. Fellow Nigerians, for the first 4 weeks, most parts of our country have been under either federal government or state government lockdowns. As I mentioned earlier, these steps were necessary and overall have contributed to slowing down the spread of COVID-19 in our country. However, such lockdowns have also come at a very heavy economic cost. Many of our citizens have lost their means of livelihood. Many businesses have shut down. No country can afford the full impact of a sustained lockdown while awaiting the development of vaccines. In my last address, I mentioned that federal government will develop strategies and policies that will protect lives while preserving livelihoods. In these 2 weeks, the federal government, state governments have jointly and collaboratively worked hard on how to balance the need to protect health while also preserving livelihoods, leveraging global best practices while keeping in mind our peculiar circumstances. We assessed how our factories, markets, traders, and transporters can continue to function while at the same time adhering to NCDC guidelines on hygiene and social distancing. We assessed how our children can continue to learn without compromising their health. We reviewed how our farmers can safely plant and harvest in this rainy season to ensure our food security is not compromised. Furthermore, we also discussed how to safely transport food items from rural production areas to industrial processing zones and ultimately to the key consumption centers. Our goal was to develop implementable policies that will ensure our economy continues to function while still maintaining our aggressive response to COVID-19 pandemic. These same difficult decisions are being faced by leaders around the world. Based on the above and in line with the recommendation of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19, the various federal government committees that have reviewed socio-economic matters and the Nigerian Governors Forum, I have approved a phased and gradual easing of lockdown measures in FCT, Lagos, and Ogun states effective from Monday, 4th of May, 2020. However, this will be followed strictly with aggressive reinforcement of testing and contact tracing measures while allowing the restoration of some economic and business activities in certain sectors. Furthermore, new nationwide measures are to be introduced as follows. A. There will be an overnight curfew from 8 p.m. to 6 a.m. This means all movements will be prohibited during this period, except for essential services. B. There will be a ban on non-essential interstate passenger travel until further notice. C. Partial and controlled interstate movement of goods and services will be allowed for the movement of goods and services from producers to consumers. And D. We will strictly ensure the mandatory use of face masks or coverings in public, in addition to maintaining physical distancing and personal hygiene. Furthermore, the restrictions on social and religious gatherings shall remain in place. State governments, corporate organizations, and philanthropists are encouraged to support the production of cloth masks for citizens. For the avoidance of doubt, the lockdown in FCT, Lagos, and Ogun states shall remain in place until these new ones come into effect on Monday, 4th May 2020. The Presidential Task Force shall provide sector-specific details to allow for preparations by governments, businesses, and institutions. In respect to the above guidelines, the state governors may choose to adapt and expand these on their unique circumstances, provided they maintain alignment with the guidelines issued above. To support our businesses and traders, the monetary and fiscal authorities shall deploy all the necessary provisions needed for production to continue and thus job restored. These revised guidelines will not apply to Kano State. With regards to Kano, I have directed the enforcement of a total lockdown for a period of 2 weeks effective immediately. The federal government shall deploy all the necessary human, material and technical resources to support the state in controlling and containing the pandemic and preventing the risk of further spread to neighboring states. I wish to once again commend the frontline workers across the country who, on a daily basis, risk everything to ensure we win this fight. For those who got infected in the line of duty, rest assured that government will do all it takes to support you and your families during this exceedingly difficult period. I will also take this opportunity to assure you all that your safety, well-being, and welfare remain paramount to our government. I will also recognize the support we have received from our traditional rulers, the Christian Association of Nigeria, the Nigerian Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs, and other prominent religious and community leaders. Your cooperation and support have significantly contributed to the successes we have recorded to date. I would urge you all to please continue to create awareness on the seriousness of the coronavirus among your worshippers and communities while appealing that they strictly comply with public health advisories. I also thank the Nigerian Governors Forum and the Presidential Task Force for all their hard work to date. Through this collaboration, I remain confident that success is achievable. I also wish to thank corporate organizations, philanthropists, the United Nations system, the European Union, friendly nations, the media, and other partners that have taken up the responsibility of supporting our response. And finally, I will thank all Nigerians again for your patience and cooperation during this difficult and challenging period. I assure you that government shall continue to take all necessary measures to protect the lives and livelihoods of our citizens and residents. I thank you for listening. And may God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria.